high. Deuce is low. Call it right and win the dough on Card Shark. And here's the host of Card Shark, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, and welcome to Card Sharks, a game of decisions. Well, as we left off last time, we crowned a brand new champion. We didn't get a chance to go for the big money with the money cards. We're going to do that right now. Let's bring out this new champion, Mr. Joe Wilson. Hello there, Joe.
How are you?
Tell our friends a little bit more about yourself there.
Well, I'm originally from New Jersey, where I went to Princeton University, and I played some Major League Baseball for the Atlanta Braves.
Yeah, you're from New Jersey. I'm from New Jersey. I was born in Camden.
Okay.
And I went to Penn.
Boo.
I won't hold that against you, Joe. Good luck. Let's get to it now. Let's make a lot of money. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Okay, Joe. And here's how we do it with the money cards. You won $200 in the game, and that's yours to keep. Now we're going to give you brand new money to play with. Starting on the bottom line with $200, you bet that money as you wish with these three cards. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money. And again, it's your decision how you bet it. Minimum bets are $50 until you get to that top card, that big bet. There you have to bet at least half the money. You ready to go?
Ready.
Good luck. $200. And as in the game, you have a choice of two base cards. We have a six. You want to play that or you want to change it?
No, I'm going to change that.
All right, you have to play this one, so I hope it's a better one. It is an eight.
Okay.
Well, let's go now. We've got $200 and an eight. What's your bet here?
I'm going to go with the odds and bet $50 that the next card is higher than an eight.
Try to improve it. $50 higher than an eight. It's a four.
Okay.
You lost 50, but you're right, okay, because you got a better car. That's
sure.
A big thing. You got $150 and a four.
Okay, we're going to bet the whole 150 that the next card is higher.
Remember, if it's another four, you lose. It must be higher. $150 higher than a four.
All
it's
right.
A seven. $300 now, Joe, and a seven.
Not a good card, so I'm only going to bet $50 again. I'm going to go conservative that the next card is higher than a seven.
$50 higher than a seven. It's a three.
Okay, it's a good carry.
Again, boy, when you lose, you don't lose much. That's the way to do it. You've got $250 and a good card, the three, which
good
we
carry.
Move up. We add the other $200 of betting money. Now, $450 and a three.
Okay. I'm going to bet the entire $450 that the next card is higher.
Higher than a three. $450, all or nothing higher than a three. It's a two. Just flirting with disaster there, Joe. Come on down here. You were flirting all along there with disaster.
Well, I can't win them all. I'll win it the next time.
That's the way to feel. You're the champion. Joe's got $200. And we'll meet a new challenger on Card Sharks right after this.
Weekdays are great days for great action.
We're going to have a great contest.
Great excitement.
Isn't that great?
Great fun.
All-time great.
Great matchups.
Great. Great. Great.
It's a great way to spend the day.
Great.
Greater.
Greatest. Very nice indeed.
Daytime buzz. It's great. Today, starting at 10, only on Buzzer.
Joe Wilson, you had bad cards up there.
Oh, really bad cards.
You played them very well, I must say. Betting the 50 on the bad card, you play them well.
Well, but I didn't go home with any money.
No, but you got the 200 for the game.
We'll get it next time.
You're here?
Definitely.
All righty. Let us open the board now, and let's get to the cards. Janice and Ann, if you will, start dealing out the cards for a brand new match with a brand new player here on Card Sharks. Let's meet her right now. Nancy Beecham. Hello, Nancy. Welcome.
Hi, Jim.
Tell us about yourself.
My name is Nancy Beecham. I'm a temporarily retired savings and loan manager, and I used to race sports cars.
What's a temporarily retired, first
that
of all?
That means I'm not working.
Oh, I see.
That's a nice way of
but
saying
you want to be back.
Yeah.
What's this about racing sports cars?
I used to race sports cars.
Really? Competitively?
Yes, amateur.
Wow, you must be a very good driver. You could
I think so.
Teach me a little bit about
I'd
it.
I'd love to anytime.
Good. Good luck in the match there, Nancy.
Thank you.
And each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards. They're shuffled and cut before we go on the air. The red cards on top will be played by our champion, Joe. And the lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by the challenger, Nancy. The object of the game, to work your way across the board, predicting whether each card is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Before you can begin calling high-low on the cards, you have to first answer a high-low toss-up question, and all the toss-up questions are based on a poll of 100 people. They test your ability to judge human nature. And here comes the first question. It goes to you, Joe. We asked 100 married women in a California studio audience, when you need a little extra cash, do you ever go through your husband's pockets? How many women admitted they do?
I think quite a few women do go through their husband's pockets. I'm going to say 80 women would say that they did.
You say how many?
80. 80.
80. I'm not sure if they caught that over there. Would you repeat that again? 80.
80.
80. Thank you.
Yes.
Nancy, Joe says that 80 out of those 100 women have gone through their husband's pockets. You a married lady?
No, I'm not married.
What do you think, higher or lower?
I don't think women are that dishonest. I think it's lower.
You say lower.
Yeah.
If it is lower, you go to the board first. If not, Joe gets first crack at the cards. The actual number of married women who said they do go through their husband's pockets is 26. Very much lower. Nancy. Nancy, we'll look at your base card. Now, you won the high-low toss-up question. You have the right to change this base card if you'd like. It is a 10.
I don't like that one much. I'd like to change it.
Here's the next one off the top of your deck, and this card you have to play. It is a 2.
All right,
great
all
change.
Right. The next one is going to be higher.
Higher than a 2. Remember, if it's another 2 you lose, it must be higher.
No way.
It is a 4.
All right.
Nancy, let me caution you now. At this point, you can freeze or you can continue calling all the way across the board. But make a mistake, you lose all the cards back to your base card, and you give Joe a free crack at his cards.
I think I agree with the audience. I'm going to keep on, and I think the next one's going to be higher.
Higher than a 4. It is a 5. What'd you say, Joe?
Edging up there.
What do you say, Nancy?
The audience was good to me last time. They're saying higher again. I'll go with higher.
Oh, it's easy for them. Higher than a 5. It is a 6. Right up the line. 4, 5, 6. And, of course, as you go up the line, the odds get a little tougher. One card to go, but you could lose them all.
Did you hear them? Freeze.
You're going to freeze?
I'm going to freeze.
You're going to freeze. And that keeps Joe away from his cards. Actually, I'm not sure if that's what they were yelling, Nancy. I think that's what you wanted to hear at that point.
Might have been.
Nancy, the question to you.
Okay.
We asked 100 fifth grade children in Southern California, do you think a teacher should be allowed to spank a student who misbehaves in class? How many fifth graders said yes?
Well, my sister is a teacher, and she teaches the sixth grade. And I've watched her class. I don't think any of them would want to be spanked. I think maybe 10.
10.
That's good, 10. I like that one.
You were listening.
Wait,
like,
bring him
like
up
that
here.
Number. Joe, she says that 10 out of 100 say that a student should be spanked if he misbehaves,
well,
higher or lower.
I agree with Nancy that none of them would want to be spanked. However, I think she's a little too high. I think lower.
Even lower than that? The actual number of fifth graders who said a teacher should be allowed to spank a student is 45, not lower. Wow, Nancy, you got it. That was a big surprise. Nancy, you've got a 6. Do you want to change it or do you want to play it?
I'm going to play it.
What is this?
It's higher.
Higher. We play the best 2 out of 3. If this is higher than a 6, you have the first game in the match and $100. Higher than a 6, it's a 7. Right up the line with 4, 5, 6, 7. My goodness. Nancy, you've got game number 1 and $100. We're clear of the board. Thank you, Janice. We'll deal out new cards and play the second game of the match right after this.
Let's make a deal. Burnishing the Fun. Tonight at 8 on Buzzer.
And Nancy, our challenger, is one game and $100. You said a nice thing during the break there, Nancy, that you're having fun. That's good.
You betcha. This is a blast.
Let's deal out the cards now for the next game of the match. Same 2 decks of cards. And Joe, the question to you. We polled 100 women in a California studio audience and asked them, now be honest, have you ever looked at a man and wondered how he would look with his clothes off? How many women said they have looked and they have wondered?
Can I ask Nancy if she would look? I think that quite a few women have looked and wondered. I'm going to say 80.
80. 80 out of 100 have looked and wondered what a man would look like with his clothes off, Nancy, higher or lower?
Well, it's my feeling that most women are intrigued by what a man looks like with his clothes on. They'll worry about the rest of it later, I think it's lower.
You say lower. Yeah. Boy, you'll be a good politician, Nancy. The actual number of women who said they have wondered how a man would look without his clothes is 69. It's lower, Nancy. Nancy will look at the base card. It is a 3.
Guess what I'm going to do? I think the next one's higher.
You're going to play it higher than a 3.
All
it's
right.
Another 3. It's not higher. Yeah. Heard you saying, all right, Joe, because you get a free crack at your cards with that mistake. You've got a 9. You can't change it. You didn't win the question. You must play it. Call this next card.
I'm going to guess that the next card is going to be lower.
Lower than a 9. It's a 3.
I'll continue, and the next card will be higher.
Higher than a 3. That's another 3. Same thing happened to you that happened to Nancy. Janice, if you'll fill in the spaces, please. No one could advance in the question to you, Nancy. We asked 100 priests across the country, have you ever played bingo? How many priests says they played bingo?
Oh, gosh.
We always hear them associated with bingo, but do they play bingo?
I don't know whether priests gamble or not. I know they do some other things. I would say probably 50 of them.
50 of them. Right up the middle. She says 50 priests have played bingo. Higher or lower, Joe?
Well, I think priests get involved in a lot of things, and bingo can be played for fun, so I'm going to say the number's going to be a little higher than it.
Higher than that. The actual number of priests who said they have played bingo is 72. Higher, Joe. Very much higher.
Oh, let's get rid of the 9.
Yeah, you can get rid of that 9 now, and we have a queen.
Right, okay. I'll say the next card is going to be lower.
Lower than a queen. It's a 7.
I'm going to freeze.
Freeze it on that 7, needing just 3 cards, and we can't take those 2 away from you. You look happy about that one, Joe.
Ooh, I didn't like that 7.
Wow. Question to you, Joe. We asked 100 married men in a previous studio audience. Now, since you've been married, have you and your wife gone to a drive-in movie and necked? How many men said yes?
Well, I think one of the big psychological things in keeping a marriage together is to keeping it new and different, and I think that they'd want to go to a drive-in and try that. Sure. I'm going to say 70.
70. Higher or lower than 70, Nancy?
Well, I've been married, too, and I've found that after the marriage, the romance dies a little bit, so I think it's going to be lower.
You say lower.
Yeah.
The actual number of married men who said they've gone to a drive-in to neck with their wife is 52. It's lower, Nancy. Joe, you're a little too romantic on that one. It paid off for Nancy. Nancy, you want to play this 3-hour change?
Yeah, I sure do. And I'm going to try it again and say the next one is higher.
Higher than a 3. It's an 8.
I don't like that one at all. I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze. And that makes an interesting board. Joe needs 3 cards. Nancy needs 3. And we are at the 4th and final question. It is sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. And it's going to be tough, so control is most important. Nancy, the question to you. We asked 100 people in the studio audience, are you an only child? How many said they were?
Oh. A studio audience that's a cross-section of ages. Okay, I would say, I don't think too many are only children. I would say 25.
25 out of 100 only children. Joe?
I'm sorry, can I have the question repeated?
Yes, indeed. We asked 100 people in the studio audience, are you an only child? She says 25 of them said they were.
I think it's going to be lower.
Lower. The actual number of people who said they are an only child is 5. It's much lower, Joe. Now then, Joe, listen carefully. Here's how we play sudden death. You have a 7. You can change it if you'd like and try to turn these 3 cards over. If you make a mistake, Nancy wins the game. However, you have control. You can force Nancy to play off the 8, which she cannot change. She would have to turn these 3 cards over or the game is yours. Your decision. You want to play it yourself with these 3 or force Nancy to play it with these?
Jim, it's a long way to go. I think Nancy's a lovely lady. If she wins it, she deserves it. Be my guest.
You're going with Nancy. All right, Nancy. If you can turn them all over, you have won the match, and you'll play the money cards. If not, we've got a tie. You've got to do it with this eight and call this.
I think the next card is higher.
Higher. Higher than an eight. It's a seven. It's not higher, and Joe wins the game and ties it up. Good strategy there, Joe. We've got a tie. Janice, if you'll deal out the cards for the tiebreaker, we will get to the tiebreaker. We've got a tie at 1-1. Nicely done there, Joe, with the strategy. It's a tough way to go with those three cards. 1-1, tiebreaker, three questions, just three cards up there on the board as we move over the bar. Thank you, ladies. Question to you in the tiebreaker, Joe. Okay. We asked 100 men in a California studio audience, would you be nervous in a 747 plane if you discovered the pilot was a woman? How many men said they would be nervous?
Oh, my goodness. Having worked for an airline, I think that most people would realize that the person up there was very qualified. So I'm going to say, the question was how many...
How many would be nervous?
Would be nervous.
Yes.
I'm going to say 10 would be nervous.
10. Nancy, higher or lower than 10? With a woman pilot.
I think more men would be nervous. I don't think they have much faith in us. I would say higher.
You say higher. The actual number of men who said they would be nervous with a woman pilot is 17. It's higher. Nancy. Nancy, we'll look at that all-important base card in the tiebreaker. It is a 7. Do you want it?
No, I don't want it. Let's change it.
An 8.
All right. All right. The next one's got to be lower.
Lower than an ace. It is a 10. What are you going to do, Nancy?
I'm going to say it's lower.
You're going to go for
it. I'm going to go for it and say it's lower.
This is lower. You are the new champion. Lower than a 10. It's a jack. It is not lower. You lose those two cards. A break for Joe, who must play a 4. Call this, Joe.
We're going to go for it. It's going to be higher.
Higher than a 4.
Okay.
It is a king.
Definitely lower.
If this is lower, you remain the champion. Definitely and play lower. The money cards for the win. Lower than a king. It's a queen. He did it. Congratulations. Great comeback, Joe. Nancy, you played very well.
Thank you.
I hope you did have fun. Thank you for coming, Nancy. Joe, come on down here with me. We'll take a break for a moment and then the money cards with Joe Wilson right after this.
Rayburn, Dawson, the long mic.
That is absolutely correct.
The longer kiss.
I've gotten aroused.
Two originals, 2 hours. Match Game and Family Feud together again. Today at 10, only on Buzzer. Let's play.
Okay, Joe, here we go again with the money cards. Let's do it this time.
Okay, hope for some better cards.
And if you will, start dealing out the cards again. $200 on the bottom. These are brand new deck of cards, shuffled and cut. And, of course, the $200 you won in the game, again, is yours to keep. Second line, another $200. Bet it as you will, $50 minimum bets until that big bet. And there you've got to bet at least half the money. Ready to go?
Ready.
$200. And this base card. It is a 7. Do you want it?
We'll change that.
Change that quickly. You must play this one. It's a 3.
Okay.
That's a good one. Okay.
We'll bet the entire 200 higher. Higher.
$200. Higher than a 3. It's a king.
All right.
That's the way to get them. Very much higher.
We'll bet the entire 400 lower.
$400. Lower than a king. It's a 2.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
800.
The entire 800 higher.
$200. Higher than a 2.
Oh, yes.
3. I said 200, I meant 800 on the 2. You're getting me nervous. $1,600 and a good card of 3 up to the second level. That at $200. Now, you've got $1,800 and a 3, Joe.
Jim, I came with nothing. The entire 1,800 higher.
Okay. $1,800. Higher than a 3. It's an 8. $3,600 and an ace.
I've got to go for it. I'm a gambler at heart. The entire $3,600 lower.
All of it again. $3,600 lower than an ace. It's a 6.
Oh, yeah.
$7,200 and a 6 now, Joe.
I'm going to bet $200 higher.
All right, try to improve it for that big bet. $200 higher than a 6. It's a 4. still, I think, a good bet, a good trade-off. You lost $200, but you gained a better card. As we move the four up here. Now, Joe, listen carefully. The big bet. You must bet at least $3,500. You can bet more. You have $7,000 and a four.
Jim, I'm going to bet $5,000 higher.
You ever bet that much money, Joe?
Yes.
$5,000 higher than a four. For $5,000, bet. Oh, no! Joe, you win those cards up here, but you got $2,000, okay. Which is great.
It's okay.
Come on down here. Oh. You were going for the biggies.
I was going for it. Had to go for it.
Did good, though. $2,000 on it. Okay.
Yeah.
And you're still here with $2,400. Joe Wilson's a gambler and a fine champion. Can he do it again? We'll find out. We'll be right back right after this.
Up next, contestants try to match wits with insane celebrities while Gene Rayburn tries to control it all on a buzzer double play of Match Game. Next, stay tuned.
We'll see you all next time on Card Sharks. Joe will be back. I hope you will be too. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience will receive a Eureka Whisk hand vac with attachments, a light, versatile vacuum cleaner for home, cars, workbenches. This Eureka even grooms pets. And some of our contestants will receive the Hamilton Beach Mini Drip Coffee and Tea Maker. Brews 2 to 4 cups in minutes. Fresh hot coffee, only when you want it. Eliminates waste. Hamilton Beach Scoville. And the Jovan collection of aftershave cologne. Exciting musk oil, mysterious ginseng. Provocative sex appeal and elegant monsieur Jovan. Wear them all. And WestClocks looks ahead in time. The smartly styled compact Big Ben solid state LED digital AM, FM, instant on clock radio from WestClocks by Tally Industries. And a true test waffle baker and grill from True Value Hardware Stores, who combine value and personal service in over 5,000 locations nationwide. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.